One of the most fundamental divisions between forms of government is between presidential and parliamentary systems. This video describes how each of these systems works and highlights some of their implications for the representativeness and stability of democracy. Presidential systems are governments where the president is the head of government as well as the head of state. In other words, where the president is the person in charge of running the country. In these systems, the president is typically elected directly by the general public. There's also a separation of executive power, which is located in the president and the bureaucracy, from legislative power, which is located in the parliament. Presidents typically serve a fixed term in office, normally 4 to 5 years, and are chosen by elections that are held at regular intervals. Examples of presidential democracies include Brazil, Argentina, Chile, much of Latin America, in fact, as well as the United States, of course. In parliamentary system, the head of government is the prime minister. The prime minister is elected by a majority in the parliament, which can also remove him or her from power through a vote of no confidence. There is no separation between the executive and legislative branches of government. The bureaucracy reports to the parliament itself through the prime minister. And it is often the case that the prime minister can call an election whenever he or she feels it's most appropriate. So they're not having elections every 4 years. They might be 3 years between elections at one time, or 5 years the next time. Examples of parliamentary systems include Canada, Japan, India, and much of the EU. Parliamentary systems might have presidents, but in these countries, the president only has a ceremonial role as head of state. For example, Israel has a prime minister, currently Benjamin Netanyahu, and a president, who is currently Reuven Rivlin. Both of these are selected by parliament, but Netanyahu is the one who runs the country. President Rivlin signs laws and treaties approved by the Knesset, but doesn't play a role in passing them. You can think of ceremonial heads of state as performing roles similar to the Queen in the UK. Finally, there are mixed or semi-presidential systems. These countries have both a president and a prime minister, and they both have power within the government. Examples include France and Taiwan. In both of these countries, the president is directly elected and appoints the prime minister in the cabinet, but the parliament has the ability to remove the prime minister through a vote of no confidence, just like a parliamentary system. Presidential and parliamentary systems each have their disadvantages. Presidential systems can be prone to gridlock and executive aggrandizement. They experience gridlock because there is this separation between executive and legislative power. If they're not held by the same political party, it can be difficult to pass legislation. They are prone to executive aggrandizement or democratic collapse, simply because they already concentrate a significant amount of power in the hands of one person. Juan Linz, in his famous article called The Perils of Presidentialism, also noted that presidential systems can be prone to collapse because electing a single person tends to portray politics as a zero-sum game. You either win everything when you win the presidency, or you lose everything. Parliamentary systems, on the other hand, can be weak on accountability for two reasons. First, prime ministers are not actually directly elected by the public. They are typically the leader of the party with the most seats in parliament. This makes it easy to remove a prime minister, but when a leader resigns, the party chooses the new prime minister, not the public. For example, when Shinzo Abe resigned as prime minister of Japan in August 2020, his party selected his deputy Yoshihide Suga as the new party leader, who then became prime minister after a vote in the full diet. Similarly, when Theresa May resigned as the British prime minister in July 2019, Boris Johnson became PM after a vote within the Conservative Party. The second weakness, and strength, frankly, of parliamentary systems is that they are run by coalition governments. This is good for representativeness because a wide range of political views are included in government, but they can also be unstable and weak in accountability. Coalition governments can be short-lived if they are based on convenience as opposed to a more durable agreement. For example, Israel held elections in April 2019, September 2019, and March 2020 in an effort to get a configuration of parties that could form a stable government. In addition, having multiple parties responsible for passing legislation can make it difficult to identify just one party to give credit or blame to if a voter wants to vote retrospectively or based on party's past performance in an election. These ideas will be further discussed in the reading for this week by Jose Chebub on presidentialism and parliamentarism.